Well, we're still doing the Southwest Region NMRA convention.
Right.
And we thought we would talk a little bit about our drive back and forth. We took Highway 89.
Right, it's scenic.
It's one of the most scenic drives there is in America. And anyway, you have a lovely connection to Highway 89.
Right, Highway 89 just cuts right through the area where I lived.
There are these kind of infamous roads. They say US 50 is the loneliest highway in America.
Then there's the infamous Route 66.
And the infamous Route 66, all 2,000 miles of that.
But if you're looking for a scenic byway to travel that goes from north to south, Highway 89 is your highway. So starting at the Canadian border, right there is Glacier National Park as your first visit.
And then continuing south down through Montana, this is the road that goes directly through Yellowstone National Park. Right there, it goes right in front of Old Faithful Geyser.
Right.
And then it's the entrance to Grand Teton National Park as it continues south.
Which you don't want to miss that. That's really neat. And Jackson Hole.
Oh, Jackson Hole is fun. And then down past one of our favorite places, Bear Lake.
Right, but then don't forget Star Valley around Afton. That is a really scenic area.
And then through Logan and the Logan Canyon.
Right.
Oh, just an amazing trip. And then right along the Wasatch Front from Ogden to Provo.
Right. So when you travel south of Provo to Spanish Fork, for a little while Highway 89 is combined with Highway 6, but it does cut off at Billy's Mountain and head down through Fairview, Mount Pleasant, and San Pete County in general, and that's where I lived.
And then Panguitch is the entrance to Bryce Canyon National Park.
Right.
And Mount Carmel is the entrance to Zion National Park.
Right. From there, you'll have some of the most scenic views driving to Kanab, which is kind of Utah's Hollywood.
Right. And then from there, at Page, you've got the Glen Canyon Dam.
Exactly.
And Lake Powell.
Right.
And then right along the south rim of the Grand Canyon.
Right.
Anyway, on to Flagstaff, which is where the convention was.
Right.
With a little side trip over to Sedona.
Yes.
Where we saw a couple of amazing model railroads.
Oh, no kidding.
At Jerome and at Cornville.
Right. After Flagstaff, Highway 89 is kind of covered up by a few freeway systems, but it does go down through Phoenix and Tucson and right by the Saguaro National Park and then onto Nogales at the Mexican border.
So the most direct route for us, and certainly the most scenic route to Flagstaff, was down 89.
Right.
But there's a very, very interesting place along 89, not well known.
Oh, well, it is to me, but...
Well, it's one of our favorite places.
Exactly.
So there's that.
So just south of Richfield, Utah, on Highway 89 in Marysvale Canyon, is the Big Rock Candy Mountain. Check it out.
This was made famous by Burl Ives.
Right.
He did that song that was a big hit, Big Rock
the
Candy
Big Rock
Mountain.
Candy Mountain.
But there's this resort, kind of a motel and cafe, and just a fun little place to stop.
Exactly.
Back before the freeways, when 89 was a much, much more major thoroughfare, this was a very happening little roadside attraction.
Right. There were so many of these back in the day. All these little roadside pull-offs and kind of a little bit of kitsch going on there.
Yeah, yeah.
But this was the place.
But it's also quite the beautiful place to stop if you find yourself on 89. It's well worth stopping here.
Oh, absolutely. Well, typical of these little roadside attractions, when the freeway bypasses them, the Big Rock Candy Mountain did fall on some hard times. But right now it's under brand new ownership, and the new owners have really gone all out to make this a really fun place to stay.
And from a train fanatic's point of view, there's something else going on here that's very interesting. This is the old Marysvale branch of the Denver and Rio Grande Western, which was abandoned in 1983. And now it's a bike trail and hiking trail. Really well done. But right here at the Big Rock Candy Mountain, they've also created Caboose Village.
Right. I remember seeing this here a few years ago before we met, and it was just, what in the world are they doing with all these caboose?
Yeah, so you've got the regular motel, and now you have this part of the motel and campground, which is the Caboose Village.
Right.
I'm putting a link in the description, so if you want to find this place or, you know, make reservations and stay here, you can chase that link in the description.
Right, and if you do stay here, keep in mind it is like camping, and you'll want to bring plenty of your own provisions because this is very rural Utah where the towns are really small. There's not a lot of stores.
You're also right on the Sevier River, and that's very scenic and beautiful. But the whole thing comes together quite nicely as a fun sort of camping experience.
Oh, it is. I just really enjoyed it at night. It was just so pleasant with the crickets chirping. It was wonderful.
So there's several different cabooses that you can rent for the night. You can also stay in a boxcar,
right,
which have been converted into a living space. And they also have a retired passenger car.
Right, and that sleeps a lot of people. So if you've got a large group, that's the one for you.
They've really fixed the insides up really nice.
Right, they are just like a little motel room.
We wanted to reserve the Union Pacific Wide Vision Caboose.
Right. However, I wouldn't mind making a trip down here and spending a night in each and every one of them at some point.
That's right. This one has the sort of unique advantage that it's right here by the railroad crossing arms.
Right.
But the deck also has a perfect view of the river.
Oh, yes. The insides have been fixed up really, really nice, almost like a little cabin in this case. I love the Union Pacific sign. And this was the best one yet, the 4014.
Certainly one of our favorite locomotives.
Oh, right.
You know, it's on display right now in Omaha.
Oh, cool.
Well, anyway, let's head on to the convention.
Right.
If you're not a subscriber to the channel, please subscribe to the channel.
Right.
And the easy way to subscribe is by clicking on the upcoming blue button. Are we ready for that? Zoink! Right there,
there
the blue
is.
Button. Well, we're not sure how you found this video on the internet. We hope you didn't find it boring, and we will see you here on Sunday. With some more fun.
Oh, yes.
We'll see you then.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Bye.